In this video, I want to look at the Node Package Manager. What is the Node Package Manager? What is a Node package? Why would you want to manage packages? Who's managing them for you? All that sort of stuff. So what is this thing? Why do you need it? And why is it relevant in particular for this context of building a Twitter bot with Node? Okay, so I'm going to come over here to the whiteboard. Not really sure why just yet. But so Node Package Manager is typically referred to online as NPM. If you Google NPM, you'll probably find the Node Package Manager website. This is not a separate thing that you need to install. When you installed Node, NPM came with it. And NPM is another command that you can run from terminal, from a console, and execute various things associated with the project. So the first thing that we... Okay, so let's think about it. So why does this thing exist anyway? So you're writing code. You're a person who's working on something with code, and you have this idea because you want to work with an API, or you want to generate SVG PDF images for some other thing, right? And you're working in JavaScript and Node, and you're, well, how do you do that? So it's very rare that you're just going to build everything from nothing. You're just going to start from a totally clean slate. All you have is JavaScript in front of you, and you're going to somehow build an entire engine that renders PDFs or talks to the New York Times API. Most likely, you want to use somebody else's library of code that they've made available, open source to you, that you can kind of piggyback off of, and hopefully you might contribute back to it or make your own packages someday. But this is what a package is. So the particular package that I feel weird saying, because I don't know, twit is like a weird thing to say, but the particular package that I'm going to use in these particular videos about making a Twitter bot is a package called twit. Because I am a twit. Let's just all get that out there. That's who I am. I am a twit. I am not, I always forget to reset these cameras. I'm a twit for not resetting the cameras. Okay, so I don't even know what that is. What is a twit? Package, NPM. So how do you install a package? You say NPM install the name of the package. So where do you say that? When do you say that? How do you do that? So one of the things that happens when you work on a Node project is that you want to have this thing, this file called package. So as you saw, you can just write some JavaScript in the previous video. You can just write some JavaScript code, execute the JavaScript code, it works. But when you start to like think of a project you're making that has a bunch of different components and imports various packages and might depend on other modules, you can keep using all these different kinds of words. This file called package.json is like, you can think of it as like your settings file for your whole project or your config file for your whole project. And one of the things that you might put in a package.json file is other types of other, what's known as other dependencies. Dependencies. Whatever, got close enough. So, and notice here the file extension .json. This is a file that's of the JSON format. Magic link to video that I made about JSON and what that is. Make that appear in an annotation or a card or something. I don't know. You could start to write this file yourself, but one of the things you can do with Node Package Manager is say npm init. So that's the very first thing that I think I'll demonstrate to you as I come over here. So I'm going to minimize Chrome, and I'm going to come back here. Now remember, I'm going to say, by the way, something I like to type is clear, which just clears the terminal on a Mac. I'm going to say pwd. So I'm in, you know, processing desktop YouTube code. This is the folder that I'm in. And actually, something I could do is say open dot. What that's going to do is open that folder in the Finder. So I want to kind of go back here, and I'm going to make another folder called Node 2. And what I want to do is now cd dot dot will move me up one directory. So you can see I'm just in the YouTube code directory. And now I'm going to go to cd Node 2. So now I'm in this folder, right? You can see it there. There's nothing in there. And now's the time where we're going to say something exciting. I'm going to say npm init. So what this does is it's telling me this utility will walk you through creating a package.json file. It only covers the most common items and tries to guess sensible defaults. So this is useful to you. You don't have to do it this way. You could make the package.json file yourself, but npm.init will kind of prompt you to ask you some questions like, what's the name of your project? Node 2, you know what, let's call it npm demo. By the way, no spaces can go in this name, which will often trip me up because sometimes it won't tell you until the end. So npm demo, the version, like if I'm keeping track of versions of projects, whatever, 1.0 sounds good. The description, I am demonstrating npm. Entry point, this is a key question. What's the name of the file that Node should trigger to run your program? I called it hello.js before. You could call it index.js. You could call it server.js. You could call it bot.js. Let's call it bot.js because that's ultimately what we're going to make eventually, although this isn't really a bot yet. Test command, whatever. I don't know what that is. Let's skip that. Git repository, that's another topic for another time. I'm not going to worry about a Git repository right now. Keywords, rainbow, awesome, whatever. Awkward maybe is more appropriate for me. And the author is myself, whatever. None of this matters. This matters if you're old and licensed. Eventually, and it's like saying, does this look right to you? And I'm just going to say yes. So what you're seeing here is it's creating that package.json file. A lot of that doesn't really matter to you right now, but it's kind of good practice to get started with it because ultimately you might want to release this as a kind of published project or open source it, upload it to this thing called GitHub, make it an official a Node package that other people can use. There's lots of possibilities here. So you're kind of getting off on the right foot by starting with this package.json file. So now if I go into Sublime here and I'm going to say file.open, and I'm just going to open. One of the things you can do with Sublime is you can open. Sublime, by the way, is a text editor that I'm using. It's not free, although you can download kind of a free version. But you can use any text editor for the stuff that I'm doing. Text edit will work. So one thing you can do with Sublime is open a full directory. And you can see now here on the side here, I have kind of a directory structure, and what I want to do is look under Node 2, and you can see, look at that. That file didn't exist. I didn't make that file. This file arrived because I ran npm init. So I can click on this file, and you can see there's the JSON file. It's got the name, the version, it's got this thing called scripts, it's got some keywords, it has no author, but I can now edit this file and just change it manually, like, oh, I wanted to have a period here, that sort of thing. So you now have a package.json file. OK, so now I said that I wanted to use the twit package. So how do you find out what packages you want, what you might want to use, and how do you install them? So I can go back to Chrome here, go back to a browser. And I'm just going to Google npm, and I'm going to end up on the npmjs.com website. So this is a website which has a collection of all packages that you could possibly think of installing. And for example, one of the ones that I hope to make some videos about at some point is this package called Express. And this is what you really want to use if you want to like make a quick web server, if you want to host some files, if you want to kind of spin up your own API. And I would like to get to, make a set of videos about using Express. But we're here and we're like, okay, well, let's say I want to use something that's going to help me talk to Twitter. So I could type Twitter in the search and you can see, wow, there's a lot. Easy Twitter, Twitter.js, Twitter tokens, Twitter 1.1, Twitter command. So this now becomes, this is your life. Welcome to your life. Maybe you should go do something else. But like, how do you pick which one? What do you do? So a lot of this is, ask a friend who maybe already made something with Twitter. I could be your friend. I might tell you, use that Twit one. It seems to be working for me. Why don't you try it? But another thing you could do is kind of look at it. You can see, does it have good documentation? When was the last time it was updated? Like if it hadn't, if the last time a code update, like if I look at this one, S auth Twitter,
We can see here, there's not really like a huge amount of documentation. It was published a year ago. 0.0.1 is the latest release. Like I might say, I don't wanna like, this is maybe a wonderful package. I don't even know who made it or why it's there, but this is the kind of things you might wanna look for. And certainly clicking over to the GitHub repository, which is where the source code, you can find the source code for it. And you could see here that, September 5th, 2014, it's only had like four commits. So maybe this isn't a sort of actively maintained project. I'm gonna look for the Twit one. I'm just gonna put in Twit here. And I think you can see here, this is a Twitter API for Node. It says REST, if you wanna take a rest, which you might want to after watching this video, and streaming. So this is good. We're going to use this streaming feature of the API. What's streaming with the API? It's kind of exciting. And you can see here, it's giving you a little message of how, I'm standing in front of it. I have this bad habit of how to install it, npm install twit. It's giving you some like example code of how to use it. Ooh, this looks like it's got pretty good documentation and information. So this is a good one to use, and I'm going to use it for my examples. So now, how do you install it? Now, we saw that on the page, it said you could say npm install twit. And this will, in fact, install the twit package. However, what I might suggest to you that you do is also type in dash dash save. What dash dash save as an argument to npm install means is save a reference to this particular package to your package.json file. And so now, if I hit enter, some stuff is happening. It's warning me because I didn't really fill out everything in that npm package. It's installed a whole bunch of things. Like twit actually depends on all these other packages that it's using. One's called Tough Cookie, which I am not a tough cookie. I'll melt very easily. You know, give me a package that's not well, that doesn't have good documentation, and I'm weeping instantly. I don't know why I'm talking about that. So you can see it installed that. And now a couple things. One is you can see, look at this. Dependencies. Right now in my package.json file, it added this so that as this project moves around or gets uploaded or shared, I'll always remember that this package, this project I'm working on, requires this twit dependency, which will help it if you're like deploying to a server and the server is going to automatically install the dependency for you. There's all sorts of possibilities there for why this might be useful. And also another thing you'll notice is that there's suddenly now, remember I'm in Node 2, if I go into this folder, there's suddenly, in addition to the package.json file, there's a Node modules folder. And that Node modules folder, you'll notice, has the twit module. And that has examples, library, other modules, it depends on tests, the README file. So all of the stuff for that particular Node module is now in the local directory for your project. So now, we are ready. Now we're actually ready to write some code. I know it's kind of been a long journey here of like, first you gotta install Node, then you gotta learn what this npm thing is, then you gotta like do npm init, and then you gotta do npm install. But all of this, it has a purpose. It has a greater purpose because we're gonna get to the fun part of actually talking to Twitter, posting to Twitter, coming up with weird, strange things that you might do automatically with a Twitter bot. So if you're following along, what I would make sure you can do now is make a package.json file, run npm init, run npm install twit dash dash save, then you'll be ready for the next video. We're going to start actually adding the code for talking to Twitter. And I'm going to hit stop.